Hi friends, in this video we are going to see how the concept of supermesh can be applied to solve a numerical. So let's take a numerical. So I have taken a problem where voltage source of 5 volt is given, current source of 2 ampere and resistances are of 4 ohm, 3 ohm and 5 ohm. Objective is to get current flowing through 5 ohm using mesh analysis. So let's start. 1, 2, 3 loops are there. I1 loop current 1, loop current 2 is I2 and loop current 3 is I3. Based on the direction of currents, let's mark polarities of voltage drops. Now there is a current source between two loops. So first let's write the equation of this current source. So I will take the current source branch, and for this branch I1 is flowing downward and I2 is flowing upward. Current source is having an upward direction, so obviously I2 is more than I1. So I can say I2 minus I1 equal to 2. Let's rearrange the terms properly, meaning first I will write I1 and then I2, I will get 2. So ultimately minus I1 plus I2 equal to 2, equation number 1. Now there is a current source between two loops, so obviously I have to consider a super mesh. So let's draw super mesh. So this is a battery of 5 volt, this resistance is of 4 ohm and this resistance is of 3 ohm. Here the polarity of voltage is plus minus because of I1 and plus minus because of I3. Similarly for 3 ohm, plus minus because of I2 and plus minus because of I3. So let's apply KVL to super mesh. So I will get minus 4 I1 plus 4 I3 minus 3 I2 plus 3 I3 plus 5 equal to 0. Let's simplify. So after simplifying, I will get minus 4 I1 minus 3 I2, 4 and 3 will become 7. 7 I3 equal to minus 5. This is equation number 2. And third equation I will obtain by applying KVL to loop number 3. So here, if I apply KVL to loop number 3, I will get these 3 elements and drop across them will be minus 5I3, minus 3I3, plus 3I2, minus 4I3, plus 4I1 equal to 0. And after simplifying, I will get 4I1 plus 3I2 minus 5 minus 3 minus 4 will give you minus 12I3 equal to 0, equation number 3. solving equation 1, 2 and 3, I will get I1 equal to 0.8571 ampere. I will get I2 2.8571 ampere, and I3 I will get as 1 ampere. The question asked was to get current flowing through the 5 ohm resistance. So for 5 ohm resistance, I3 is the current. So I3 or current flowing through 5 ohm resistance is same as I3, is nothing but 1 ampere. And since I am getting the answer positive, I can draw the direction like this. So here we have seen how to apply the concept of super mesh and get an answer for a current flowing through any of the resistance given in a circuit. In subsequent videos, we will solve more numericals based on the concept of super mesh. Thank you.